much biology. Don't know much about us.
The Iron Lady of the Western World.
I have the same contempt for his socialist policies as the people of East Europe who have experienced it have it for that. He would rather the poor were poorer, provided the rich were less rich. That way you will never create the wealth for better social services as we have.
No, no, no. We're all unequal. No one, thank heavens, is quite like anyone else, however much the socialists may pretend otherwise.
There is no such thing as public money. There is only taxpayers' money.
I seem to...
Ours was the first revolution in the history of mankind that truly reversed the course of government, and with three little words. We, the people. We, the people, tell the government what to do. It doesn't tell us. We, the people, are the driver. The government is the car. And we decide where it should go, and by what route, and how fast. Almost all the world's constitutions are documents in which governments tell the people what their privileges are. Our constitution is a document in which we, the people, tell the government what it is allowed to do. We, the people, are free. This belief has been the underlying basis for everything I've tried to do these past 8 years. But back in the 1960s, when I began, it seemed to me that we'd begun reversing the order of things. That through more and more rules and regulations and confiscatory taxes, the government was taking more of our money, more of our options, and more of our freedom. I went into politics in part to put up my hand and say, stop. I was a citizen politician, and it seemed the right thing for a citizen to do. I think we have stopped a lot of what needed stopping, and I hope we have once again reminded people that man is not free unless government is limited. There's a clear cause and effect here that is as neat and predictable as a law of physics. As government expands, liberty contracts.